In previous videos of this series, we saw Chad turning the blanks on the Doosan Lynx. Now we're gonna talk about milling it on our Akuma 560V. So I wanna talk a little bit about the capability of this machine. It's got a three-axis setup over here on a riser plate, set up with a Lang quick point system, which is really flexible, allows us to do a lot of good three-axis work over here. But what's real important for this project is this Nikon five-axis rotary. So that allows us to do that simultaneous roughing, that simultaneous five-axis roughing we're going to be doing on this impeller. You'll notice there's a custom fixture that's been set up here, and we're gonna cover that in some other videos. So we're not gonna talk about that here. We're gonna really focus on cutting this impeller part. So let's get this bolted up and start roughing on it. If you're not a confident five-axis programmer, you may lean on what you already know and resources you have, creating planes and 3+2 roughing. So let's start with that. 3+2 roughing is definitely a viable option for this project. Now, we don't wanna just go at the whole part and attack it all in one go. Instead, let's prove things out on one segment and then transform that around. Let's take a look in Mastercam. So to start with, we'll do an OptiRough from the top plane. The results yield us a stock model that looks something like this. Now, we're not getting a lot of material out of these areas, right? You can still see in between the splitter and this rightmost blade, there's a lot of material still left in there. So the best way to get that out with a 3+2 roughing strategy is to tilt and look along that plane. You know, just get your graphics view in an orientation that looks like you could remove a lot of material. Go to the Planes Manager and create a new plane. And I'll do that from graphics view. Now this creates a plane in the orientation of the part as I'm looking at the screen. So we can call this Rest Rough 2. I'll click OK. And then I would reference that plane for further OptiRests. Now, I'm not gonna do that, I've already got this programmed, but the results would look something like an OptiRest operation like this. Now, the resulting stock model there is something similar to this. This still leaves a good amount of material here. So how do I get that out? Well, I repeat the process. This is an iterative process. Create an OptiRough operation, create a stock model, create a new plane, a new OptiRough operation, a new stock model. Is very successful, but it is a lot of work. So once we get this all done, we end up with a stock model that looks something like this. We're very close to net shape. There is a little more material here. If I wanted to, I could go in with a smaller tool with another OptiRough operation and get rid of that. So with that, let's take this program over to the machine and see what it looks like. So this works very well, but it's far from perfect. Even with these awesome reduced neck ball end mills, there are still reach issues from various planes. It takes a lot of planes and a lot of time to get that material out. In future videos, we will discuss using Blade Expert to make this far easier and far more efficient to rough. So now we need to talk about the real challenge here, and that is finishing these blades. Now, doing the finishing with 3+2 operations and using standard 3D surface finishing operations really isn't ideal, and it's not going to leave a good finish part quality. So let's look at doing this in full simultaneous five axis. So some impeller blades actually are able to be swarfed, and that makes it really easy. It's one pass, you finish the whole blade. But these blades, if we look at them, they have a concave and convex feature to them, and that can't be done with a swarfing toolpath. So we've got to surface machine these. Now, the way that I would suggest doing this is moving into the toolpaths and use a multi-axis unified. For this, we're going to use the Harvey tapered end mill. And for a cut pattern, I'm going to use curves. Now I want to set these up and I'll pick my top edge here. And I'll move across the part. And I'm just gonna do one side at a time here. I'll add another curve row and pick this bottom edge. And rather than guide, I'm going to use a morph strategy here. For my surface, I'm going to pick this blue surface. Tool axis control, I'll do a surface with tilt, and I'm going to tilt it at about 70 degrees. I'll shut off collision control for now and make sure that's off, and click OK. This will generate the tool path. Now, really quickly, really easily, I've got a great looking tool path here. Do a quick back plot on there, and you'll see that tool is moving right across that surface, just as I would expect. So that may have looked simple to program, and that was no accident. I picked the easiest face on that entire part. Now we still have the splitter, we have the hub, and we have the other side of that blade we've got to program. But for now, I'd like to show it to you on the machine. I've simulated it, and I'm ready to go. So let's take a look. Now this is a morph pattern, just like we defined in Unified, where we morphed from the shroud down to the hub. And this is pretty much what it's going to look like. Now, if we move over back over here to Mastercam, I'd like to show you some of the flexibility that Unified has, right? If I come into the parameters, I can very easily get rid of one of these rows, switch over to a guide curve here, and regenerate. Upon regeneration, you'll see that now that cut pattern is staying parallel to this top curve, right, all the way down. Now, is that totally desirable? Well, maybe not really, because that is creating some retracts there, but it does show the flexibility of the new Unified toolpath. So the flexibility with the Unified toolpath is one of its greatest benefits. You can change strategies without exiting out of and restarting a new toolpath. That's really handy. Now, I may have made that look pretty simple when programming this part, but in reality, this is going to be very difficult when we get down into the hub and we've got to finish that hub and get between these blades. That tool axis control strategy is going to be very, very difficult to get gouge free. So over these next couple videos, I want to introduce the Blade Expert package and really show the benefits on a part like this, how we can get right in, access all those blades, all that geometry, simply, easily, and really get some optimized motion.